Hello, I'm David Kelley. I'm a senior fellow at the Atlas Society and a consultant to the Atlas Shrugged movie. The scene we're going to watch takes place at the wedding of James Taggart. He's Dagny Taggart's brother and the president of Taggart Transcontinental Railroad. Francisco D'Anconia, the mysterious figure who seems to appear at every pivotal scene, is talking about money.
Money cannot buy happiness. True words were never spoken. We're no longer chasing the almighty dollar. Our ideals are higher than profit. Instead of the aristocracy of money, we have...
the aristocracy of pull. I mean, now it's about influence, but you knew that already.
What I know is that you need to learn some manners.
You ever doubted that money was the root of all evil? There's your proof.
Oh, so you think money's the root of all evil? Have you ever asked yourself what's the root of money? Money is a tool that allows us to trade with one another. Your goods for mine. Your efforts for mine. The keystone of civilization. Having money is not the measure of a man. What matters is how he got it. If he produced it by creating value, then his money is a token of honor.
Look who's talking about honor.
But if he's taken it from those who produce, then there is no honor. And you're simply a looter.
Signor D'Anconia, we all know that money is made by the strong at the expense of the weak.
What kind of strength are you talking about? The power to create value? Or the ability to manipulate, to extort money in backroom deals, to exercise pull?
All right. Just leave.
Okay. When money ceases to be the tool by which men deal with one another, then men become the tools of men. Blood, whips, chains, or dollars, take your choice. There is no other. And your time is running out.
In the novel, Francisco's statement about money is one of the iconic moments, often cited by readers as memorable and often excerpted. In the novel, though, it is not exactly a moment. It's a long speech, making many points. The film adaptation necessarily gives just the essence, though it does add the visual reaction of the guests, who don't know whether to be astonished or offended. The astonishment's understandable. I mean, imagine someone saying these things at weddings you've been to. As for the offense, James Taggart is what we would now call a crony capitalist. His wedding guests are the elite of a politicized economy, people who have business connections with the powers that be in Washington, along with their friends and enablers in high society. Francisco punctures their self-image as do-gooders when he describes them as the aristocracy of pull. That term, the aristocracy of pull, is Ayn Rand's evocative description of takers as opposed to makers. The people at the wedding are not welfare dependents who live on benefits taken from taxpayers, but they are still takers because they depend on government favors and subsidies, extracted at the expense of genuine makers, genuine producers like Dagny Taggart and Hank Rearden. And it's really Dagny and Hank that Francisco is speaking to. I hope he caught their fascination with his words. The theme of makers versus takers runs throughout Atlas Shrugged and is highlighted in many specific forms. In this scene, the specific form is the nature and role of money, keyed off one guest's invocation of the biblical injunction, money is the root of all evil. In response, Francisco gives voice to the two central themes in the longer version of the novel, which is well worth reading in its own right. First, the fact that money is a medium of exchange. Money is a tool, he says, that allows us to trade with one another. Your goods for my goods. Your efforts for mine. That is, money is the medium in which independent people trade the products of their efforts. Think of the simplest transaction. You buy a quart of milk from the grocery store. You value the milk more than the money it costs, and the grocer values your dollars more than the milk in his store. You both win. It's an honest, voluntary, win-win exchange. Francisco's second essential point is that wealth is created by production. This is the answer to his question, what is the root of money? Money is the medium in which we exchange goods and services, just as language is the medium in which we exchange our thoughts. But just as the sounds we make in speaking or the marks we make in writing are meaningless unless there's thought behind them, so the paper we carry in our wallets is worthless unless it represents real things of value. And those things have to be produced. For all the benefits of trade, in which each side gains, what is traded has to be produced in the first place. Unless people create value through production, they can trade only a fixed stock of existing goods. But in Atlas Shrugged, as in our own world, people are continually creating new goods at lower cost by using their powers of reason. Hank Rearden's new metal, Rearden metal, is an example of in the novel. In the real world, think Bill Gates and Microsoft, Steve Jobs and the iPad, the lesser known people who have created new medical technologies. Once created, such wealth can be taken by people who did not produce it. As Francisco says, having money is not the measure of a man. What matters is how he got it. If he produced it by creating value, then his money is a token of honor. But if it was taken from those who produce, you're simply a looter. Here again, we see the contrast between makers, those who produce at any level, and those who take through government favors. Hank and Francisco are members of what is now called the 1%. So is James Taggart. Do you see how Francisco is challenging the whole idea of the 1%? It's not about how rich you are in terms of dollars. It's about how you acquired the wealth. When a society allows both ways of getting money, as ours does today, something's wrong. Francisco's money speech is a clarion call to understand the meaning of wealth. For those who earn it through honest effort, production and voluntary exchange, at any level, from the local grocer to the greatest innovators, it is indeed a badge of honor. But those who acquire wealth through pull are, as Francisco says, just looters.